Hi, thank you for watching Scripture Explorers. We love being able to teach the scriptures and help families understand them better. If you want to help us keep growing and sharing, please subscribe to our channel, like us on Facebook, and share our videos with friends and family. We also appreciate your donations. You can scan the QR code below or visit scriptureexplorers.com to donate today.
Hi, welcome back to Scripture Explorers. I'm James.
And I'm Aria.
And we're the Scripture Explorers.
James, what are we doing?
I want to follow the missionaries and see what they do.
Why are you two following the missionaries?
I wanted to see them teaching, but it seems like people aren't very nice to them. No one is listening.
Some days are like that for missionaries. It can be discouraging and hard work to preach the gospel to people. Many of the missionaries you see today have been learning about the church and reading the Book of Mormon their whole lives. But back in 1830, the church was brand new, and no one had been a member for more than a few months. But it was time to start sending out missionaries.
Did they have little name tags and more suits like they do now?
Things may have looked a little different. There was no missionary training center, and missions could last for a very long time. But what the missionaries would teach was the same. They would teach about the Book of Mormon and the Gospel of Jesus Christ.
Did people then listen more than people now?
Let's take a quick look at our restoration timeline to learn more about this. Up until now, we've been looking at the timeline that showed us many years. But today, let's look at a timeline of just the year 1830. It was a big year for the church. In March of 1830, the Book of Mormon was published. In April, the church was organized. In July, Emma started making the first hymn book. And in September of 1830, there was a conference. Just after that conference, and through the end of December, a lot of people were called to be missionaries for the church. Among those called to be missionaries were Peter Whitmer, John Whitmer, Thomas B. Marsh, and Parley P. Pratt.
Did they get to teach and baptize a lot of people?
Well, yes, they did, although it didn't happen the way they thought it would. They had been called on a mission to teach the Native Americans in some of the tribes on the American frontier. They spent a lot of time trying to teach members of these tribes, but in the end, none of them listened to the gospel message.
But you said they taught and baptized a lot of people.
They did. Those people just weren't the Native Americans. They actually had a lot of success in teaching and baptizing many people in a town called Kirtland, Ohio. Many people there joined the church as the result of these missions, and Kirtland, Ohio would later be the site of the first temple built by the saints, and even be the headquarters of the church for a time.
So it might have felt like the mission was a failure in the moment, since the Native Americans didn't listen to the message. But it turns out, God had many reasons for sending them on that mission, and building up the church in Ohio turned out to be a very important one. Over time, you'll see that many of the most important things that happened in church history happened in Kirtland, Ohio, thanks to these missionaries.
Oh look, the missionaries are talking to someone that wants to listen to them. Do you think they'll be baptized?
Maybe so. God has a way of guiding his missionaries right where he needs them, even if it's not where they expected to go.
I hope you learned a lot today. Remember to subscribe and share. Also, if you want to take your family scripture study to new levels, check out our scripture study helps at the QR code below or visit scriptureexplorers.com.